Hi, I'm Jeff Kaplan. I'm a Managing Director of Think Strategies. I'm glad to be with Malcolm Hawker. Tell us all about Pivotal IT.
Pivotal IT is a small professional services firm based out of Washington, D.C. area. We help our clients solve particularly messy and challenging technology problems, and in this case, Neustar, the client, had a very, very challenging issue.
Tell us about what the issue was.
Well, Neustar was challenged in that they grew very, very quickly. They had acquired a number of businesses over the years, 5 to 6 acquisitions over a very short period of time, and they had maintained these businesses as autonomous business units. Mm-hmm. And each of the data for those businesses resided within those businesses. So they had these silos, and even within the silos, there were silos within silos. So there were CRM systems, there were product systems, there were financial systems, and none of them talked within the silos. They didn't talk vertically, and they didn't talk horizontally.
Not an unusual problem, right?
Not an unusual problem at all. I've actually solved that a couple of other times in previous lives. But at a certain point, it's just not scalable. It can't continue to run that way. And when it gets to the point of, you know, requiring days to run aggregated customer reports to understand what's going on with our customers, it's time for something else.
So what did you do to try to address their needs?
Well, we first attacked the problem strictly as a data integration problem. We understood that to get all these systems talking and sharing information, you had to plug them in together. So you had to figure out the plumbing problem. And Pervasive is particularly good at that. Pervasive is a leader in figuring out ways to connect system A to system B. And that's how we first started to attack the problem. But we quickly figured out that there was more. And at the core, this is an operational problem to try to solve. But that's when things started to get fairly interesting.
All right. So you've been nominated for Integration Next Award, Best of Show Award. You must have done something special. Tell us what you did. Once that thread started to unravel, what was it you had to do at that point, and how did Pervasive help you in that process?
Well, what we learned was that at the core, this is an operational problem. The data obviously looks different. It was in different places. But a lot of the data was overlapping. It was incomplete. It was inaccurate. Business Unit A was allowing their salespeople to do anything in their CRM. Anybody could create an account. Anybody could update an account. And Business Unit B was completely different, had more rigorous rules, had controls in place to make sure that the data was good by the time it got into downstream systems. I think what we did that was fairly innovative from a Pervasive perspective is that we used some of their tools, particularly their match merge tool, to develop this solution that allowed us to logically group records together. In this case, it was customer records. So one of the restraints that we had, one of the constraints that we had was that we wanted to get something up and running quickly. It had to be cost effective.
Sure.
And the biggest constraint that we had to overcome was that we didn't want to enforce change within the various business units.
You don't want to change the way they operated,
correct,
basically, and get in the way of their day-to-day operations.
Okay, correct. Yep. So what we ended up building was probably, on the surface, kind of anathema to what Pervasive is trying to do, which is enforce data quality. What we ended up building was a system that allowed all of the various business units to continue to pump garbage into the system. Again, really kind of sounds
counterintuitive.
Counter to what, yep, Pervasive does, which is try to improve your data quality. But at the same time, we knew that if we went and tried to force some sort of master model that said, here's your customer list, here are the processes used to create it, only this person can create this record, only this person can create or modify that record, we knew that just wouldn't work. So what we developed, using a combination of tools, was a system that enables what's known as a registry style of master data management. So the old way of master data management is this called a federated model, where you say, okay, we'll take all the data, we'll put it into one big bucket, we'll get rid of the crap, we'll get rid of the duplicates, we'll get everything else, and we'll have this one pristine list that is the perfect gold master list. And then we'll give it to somebody in accounting or finance to manage. And then anytime you want to add somebody to the list or modify it, you have to go and ask somebody in accounting to do that. And that's kind of the old way of doing things, and we knew that wouldn't work. So what we ended up building, again, was this registry that, and I think probably the innovative bit about it is that if you have 40 records for Acme Incorporated, And in some situations, we found upwards of 40 to 50 of a single company. We did this kind of birds of a feather logic, where walks like a duck, quacks like a duck, it's got webbed feet. It's probably a duck. Verizon, 123 Elm Way. Verizon, 126 Elm Way. We found a way to logically group all of them together and to create a master ID for Verizon without actually changing any of the source data. So the data still comes into the system. Some of it's good. Some of it's bad. We created some rules within Pervasive software to say we have two hurdles. There's a bottom hurdle where two records should be grouped together if it clears, this is actually the top bar, an 80% confidence, let's just say. And we tinkered with this quite a bit. If we're 80% sure that these are actually all Verizon, let's put them together and give them a new master ID. If we're only 60% sure, somewhere between 60 and 80%, let's put these into a bucket for a human to manage, to go look at, to manually review and say, okay, yes, these are one and the same. They should be grouped together. Anything below 60% automatically was given, no grouping. It was a unique one-off, a onesie. And they all got new master IDs in and of themselves. So the data is still duplicated, and it's still within these various operating systems, but we created this registry of really kind of a key lookup system, where you have a primary key of a master ID that we're assigning now, and all of the subsystem IDs. It's got a PeopleSoft ID, it's got a Salesforce ID, it's got a product system ID, and we can tie them all together to create a consolidated, accurate customer report.
That's great. So what's been the result from the client point of view as far as all that work is concerned? How does that translate into some sort of business benefits for them?
Well, I think the biggest benefit was that we didn't try to enforce operational change. This is like a cost avoidance ROI. It's harder to measure. But we didn't have to go into all these business units and disrupt their flows, disrupt their processes. We didn't do any of that. That saved time, which is money. So we were up and running pretty quickly. In about 3 months, we had a proof of concept running that we could see was actually generating a return. So the real benefit to the customer was that we had consolidated customer reporting. We did it quickly. We didn't enforce any changes on the organization and how they do their business. So they could keep going. Pervasive is very, very good at consuming data in a lot of formats. So we didn't actually say even to get at the data. We just said, give it to us how you've got it. One group would say, okay, here's our API. Go hit our API. Life is good. That's easy. Great. The other business unit would say, well, we've got it in Excel. Okay, we'll take that. Another business unit would say, we've got it in a flat file. We take all that in, mash it together. We actually call the system a grinder. And then out would come these master IDs.
And for you, as a partner with Pervasive, any learnings or any takeaways that you've been able to gain from the event, the experience?
Well, a lot. Some we already kind of knew, trying to solve a very specific problem. Don't try to boil the ocean. We know at Neustar we eventually want to master things like leads and contacts. Those are a mess. We know it. And we want to fix that, but we didn't try to fix everything at once. We just focused on customers because that was the most important thing. Another thing that I learned as a IT consultant was that you really have to listen to your client, even if on the surface it doesn't make sense. So on the surface, you say, okay, we're trying to solve a data quality problem. Shouldn't we be improving the quality of the data? Don't you really want to say, you stop putting incomplete records into Salesforce. You want to say that. But I just listened to the client. The client said, we don't want to enforce change. We don't want to enforce change. You figure this out. Figure out a way to provide accurate customer reporting without enforcing that change. And it kind of went against a lot of, every fiber of my being to allow the garbage to keep coming in. But the product we came up with met that need. So it was, at the end of the day, listening to what the client wanted and being able to fulfill that need was rewarding.
That's terrific. Hey, Malcolm, thanks for your time.
Thank you.
Really appreciate the lessons learned, and I hope everybody else found this helpful as well. Thanks.
Thank you. Appreciate it.